Good morning friends, I am here again with another video. Today I am driving to Prashar Lake along with my friends. Prashar Lake is one of the pilgrimage place in Himachal and now a very popular tourist destination. Prashar Lake lies 49 km north of Mandi and around 45 km from Pajara. There are two ways to go Prashar by road. One is from Mandi via Katola and another one is from Pajara via Ropa and Kandi Pass. Today we are taking Pajara, Ropa, Kandi Pass route. The route is very scenic. I am visiting this temple after maybe 3 or 4 years. Last time when we are young, we used to visit this temple every year during the Soranahuli festival. During this festival, thousands of people visit this temple and take dip in this holy lake. The road from Pajara to Prashar Lake is very scenic. You can see snow-capped mountain in the distance and you will drive through the dense pine trees. Last time we always used to trek from Jolapur, which take around 5 to 6 hours to reach to this temple. Shortly, we are reaching near the temple. The view is awesome. You can see 360 degree view of the mountain from this ridge. It's quite cooling here. The air is very fresh, which gives you more energy to walk towards the temple. You can see there's around 30 islands inside the lake. The temple was built in 13th century and legend has it was built by a baby from a single tree. The lake has a floating island in it and it is said to be unclear how deep the lake is, with a diver not being able to determine this depth. It is believed that the Prashar Rishi meditated on the bank of this lake, hence it is named as Prashar Lake. Bhima, one of the Pandavas' brother, had created this lake. Story says after the Kurukshetra youth was returning with Lord Kamrunath when they reached this place. Kamrunath loves the tranquil surrounding and decides to live here forever. and his elbow. Prashar temple is dedicated to Rishi Prashar. He was the grandson of Rishi Vasishtha, a great sage in Hindu mythology. The exact history of the Prashar temple is unknown, but according to folk tales, it took around 80 years to complete its construction. Prashar Lake, due to the environment change, the lake is shrinking day by day. We also believe that the architecture belonged to that of the 14th century and was commissioned by Ban Sen, the king of Mandi state. Wooden temple has a pagoda style of architecture. It is made of deodar, pine wood and the stones. This has become a famous tourist destination despite being a pilgrimage site. It is the pride of district Mandi. This place is so beautiful that you can spend whole day easily here, walking around the temple, climb those small hills to have a beautiful view of snow-capped mountain and the pine forest and the villages in the distance. Also, an ideal retreat for nature lovers coming to this place. During winter, the snow-capped peaks look stunning as legends say Rishi Prashar meditated here. His lake coming to existence after he struck the ground with a stick from where water flows. During the month of January and February, this lake is completely frozen and one could easily walk from one corner to another corner, which is prohibited to do due to the importance of this lake. And during the winter, to treat the water, you have to hammer the lake and make a small hole so that you can treat the water from the lake for drinking purposes. To reach Prashar Lake, either you drive there, either you trek. The driving, as I told earlier, is either from Mandi or either from the Pajora. So there are many trekking routes which leads you to this beautiful Prashar Lake. We came here in the mid-March, so not much snow here around the lake. But if you come here in the end of Jan or Feb or month of December, there's tons and tons of snow. But it's not really easy to reach here during the winters, which falls from November to Feb. The only way to reach here by foot, so people do come here from Jolapur, Bandi and nearby Kotola village. The priest has to come here in the winters. During the Soranali time, there's thousands of people come here and you can see the tents all over the around the lake. There's thousands of tents and there's many shrines which belongs to the nearby villages. So the village people come here, do prayer deep into the lake and stay on these shrines. The festival lasts for 2 to 3 days. So people do come here and make a circle clockwise around the lake. So we have already circled the lake and the temple. Now we are going down to the temple. So I just took the snow route because I want to enjoy my walk on snow. So we are going towards the temple. Not many people, maybe 40 or 50 people here, but the priest stay here throughout the year. But the priests are from the different villages, so they take turn to come here and do the daily pujas in the temple. Very scenic and beautiful place it is. Temple is built in pagoda style, which are the most common temples in the Himalayan region, and there are some other temples which are in the Shikhar style. This pagoda style Prashar Rishi temple is made of wood, slate and stones. We used to go near the lake and you can touch the water, but now there's a fence all around the lake. You are not allowed to go near the lake. Jai Ho Prashar Rishi, Jai Prashar Rishi, Aapka Ashirvaad Bana Rahe, Jai Prashar Rishi. That's the end of the video. I hope you like the video. I try to create the shorter video. Actually, I have many clips, but I found it little difficult to edit in the phone. Maybe when I go back to home, I will edit it nicely. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye for now.